Today's mail opening is assisted by Infernal Fusion Machine Black Ale from Dastardly Villain Brewing in Winnipeg. They describe it as a fusion of classic Irish dry stout and a bold North American stout with espresso flavors from the roasted malt and the bold character of Maris Otter malt. I've been trying a few of their beers recently and I'm liking what I'm tasting. This one has no description, so let's go in and see what the first mystery in the mailbag is. It is a single little module. Oh, it's not a module. It's a Raspberry Pi Pico. Okay. These are Raspberry Pi's entry into the microcontroller world. Normally, Raspberry Pis are a full-featured computer, but these, I guess they came out a few years ago, have been sort of taking over from some of the traditional jobs that the old Arduino platform has been doing. Not that there's anything wrong with the Arduino platform, but this one, one of its party tricks is it can run Python, so you don't have to compile code and do all that kind of things. But they are a cool little board, quite capable, and quite affordable, if I remember correctly.
Official Raspberry Pi board, RP2040, dual core, 264K ARM, low power microcomputer, high power performance, Cortex M0 processor. It's not a microcomputer, it's a microcontroller, but other than that, it is in fact based on the RP2040 dual-core ARM chip. I paid $6.24 for this thing. They claim that they normally sell it for 19-something. I think if you can find it for $6.24, that's a pretty average price most places these days, including AliExpress. And from what I can tell, this is actually a legitimate Raspberry Pi Pico. I don't see anything with the one that I've got in front of me to tell me otherwise, but if you see any reason for me to not trust it, drop that in the comments.
Off to a fine start with a very useful piece of kit. Let's see, the next thing is, it says BNC male to female banana dual binding post adapter. Well, that's very specific. Is that what it really is? Yes, it is. This is just a test adapter. I am slowly adding to the different types of test cables that I've got. The BNC is common on higher frequency test stuff, and banana jacks are just a really useful and positive way of connecting and breaking stuff out. And this type you can connect to there, but you can also connect a test probe or something to there too. So you can have your actual circuit connected there, and then plug in there to tap off to a high impedance source like a meter or something like that. I expect that this will either end up on one of the various signal generators that I've got around here, or on the scope, or some combination of both.
One piece BNC male to female banana dual binding post adapter convert, covert from BNC plug, blah blah blah, whatever. This cost me $5.25, which is a little bit more expensive than what I normally pay for adapters and stuff, but it was surprisingly hard to find these things at a better price, so there we go. That's what I went with. I mean, there's not much more to say about it. It's just an adapter from one type of connector to another. What more do you want?
This is going along quite quickly. Let's see if we can throw a little bit of randomness in. This is something that was sent to me anonymously at my P.O. box. Let us see what we got. Ah, DuPont jumpers. Nice short ones. These always come in handy for breadboard projects. And I've received a few different donations of them in the past. I've bought various of them in the past as well. They don't last forever. They are essentially consumable, so it's always nice to have a resupply of them. And they're made out of ribbon cable, so you can just separate them into the different batches here. The colors repeat and repeat over and over again, so I think just for storage, I will break them up into those. And basically, it's 40 pins worth of jumpers.
As always, when it's something that I didn't buy myself, when it was a gift, I will put a link down below to a search on eBay that finds them, and I will always have it sorted price plus shipping lowest, because that's where you go for the best deal. Currently, it looks like there's a few packages of these that are, well, they're on auction. There's the cheapest one that's not on auction. So $1.35 with free shipping. It's hard to beat that for something that you can use for a while. And if you destroy it, you don't feel too bad about damaging it because it's so cheap. But they are super handy things to have around when you're testing and probing around on breadboards or working with Arduino projects and that kind of thing. Thanks once again to my anonymous donor.
All right, next thing in, it says machinery parts. Could be anything. Well packaged, though, well bubble packed. What do we have? Oh, it's a little solenoid. It's a couple of little solenoids. Okay. According to that, they are 5-volt solenoids. A couple of different times in past mailbags, I have received a few different solenoids. I'm just right now experimentally picking up various different ones just to see what will work for the project that I was inspired to make 6 months ago when I started ordering these things. So these ones, what have we got? About 20 centimeter long wire. Looks like they are intended to have something on them and they will pull, but you could also use them to push on this end if you wanted to, or rig something up to go in the other direction. Let me just see the other ones that I've got and see if these are the same or different. Hang on. Where are my solenoids here? There they are. Oh, these ones look, well, they're different tape color on the sides of them, so they're coming from a different supplier. But the springs feel the same, and they have the same kind of throw on them. Okay. Those ones, I believe, were 5 volts. Let's. These ones also say that they're 5 volts. So if we give them 5 volts, what happens? There we go. That works fairly well. What kind of current are we drawing? Looks like... oh, more than half an amp. Wow. What did these other ones do? These blue ones here from a few mailbags back, I guess. I don't know. Let's scroll back and find out. Oh, are those even 5-volt ones? Maybe they're 12-volt ones. Yeah, these blue ones are 12 volts. Okay. So I've got a few different options now. Those are also about half an amp, just shy. So now I've got 5-volt ones, and I've got 12-volt ones, and... like I said, these ones are pneumatic valves, so I don't think that's going to work with my project, but hopefully I'll see if I have any more coming. Maybe I do, and I might get around to that project eventually.
DC 3, 5, 6, 9, or 12 volt push-pull micro spring solenoid magnet electromagnet, blah, blah, blah. So I chose the 5 to 6 volt option. There's the other ones that they have available, and these cost me $3.52 each Canadian. Ooh, with $2 shipping as well. So actually about $5 each if you buy one, which is probably why I bought two, just to, round up the shipping. Yeah, no other description available. Oh, stroke about 4 millimeters, but we could also see that in here, I guess. All right, well, I'll set those aside until I get around to this project.
And the last... and largest package in. It does not say what it is. It makes a rattling noise. That's intriguing. Let's see what we got. Mechanical pencils and various different colors of pencil lids. Wonder why I would have ordered those. And I already have a mechanical pencil and a bunch of extra LEDs for it. Plus I have, where is it? There it is there. Well, it uses a little bit skinnier lead. Okay. So these, I think I was seeing various woodworking YouTubers using this kind of pencil for their carpentry pencil. The North American standard carpentry pencil, it has a rectangular shaft on it, so you can lay it down and it won't roll around. But I guess this pocket clip takes care of that. And these can reach deep into a hole, I guess, if you want to make a mark. And they did come with some extra colored, would you call them LEDs even if they're not LED? You know what I mean, refills, I guess. In, I've got red and yellow there. And I've got red and yellow and... Is that just the standard graphite? Sure, or whatever, pencil color. And then a bunch of that. Okay. And then two of these, so I guess I could have a color in one and standard in the other one. Sure. Not super electronics-y. Let's see what I paid for those.
Solid Carpenter pencil, built-in pencil sharpener, suitable for woodworking, architect's mechanical pencil, deep hole marking kit. Right, that is pretty much what it is. And where's the exact one that I got here? That one, I think. Yeah, two pens and three refills. So $15? Really? No, that wasn't $15. I only paid $8.76 and a bit of shipping on them. Price has changed significantly since I bought them. Regardless, what do we say down here? Deep hole manufacturer, sharper for more precise measurements, mechanical pencil, marks on different surfaces. Pre-filled with gray and comes with a refill box. Sure.
Well, that wasn't too electronics-y or exciting. You know what? Let's grab a sixth thing. From up here in the incoming mail queue, there's the next thing. It would have showed up next mailbag, but you've got it now. Hopefully this is more interesting. Maybe we can end on a higher note. What do we got here? It is... couple of banana jack test cables. Well, those will go nicely with that BNC adapter that I got earlier. And I do have some homemade. Oh, these are nice flexible silicone wire. Okay. So I'm guessing that I probably paid a little bit more than just the cheapest cables for these. And one of the many benefits of these, other than that they're silicone and probably fairly solid, is you can stack them if you want a signal to go multiple places. You can just keep stacking them forever if you, as long as you don't, impedance load something down or whatever. But why did I get two red ones and no black ones? Oh, anyway, at least it's electronics. Let's go check the listing and see what I paid for these.
One piece banana to banana test lead set, 4mm stackable banana plug, wire test cable lead for multimeter. Sure, multimeter too. Any other test situation. This shipper seems to have changed things. They don't want to sell to Canada anymore for some reason. But if you're in a country that they do sell to, they're selling for $5.72 for one right now. However, when I bought them, they were $2.79 each, and I bought two of them for $5.58 plus shipping. They say that they are 1 meter long, that they're good for 1,000 volts or 15 amps. I think they're a little bit lighter than that. They are soft and flexible. Yes, they are. I'm pretty happy about that. They say that they're copper and PVC. I'm going to say that there's some silicone there too, because it doesn't feel like the PVC that I'm used to, unless there's some sort of weird plasticizers in it or something, but it feels a lot more like silicone wire to me. Anyway, there those are. And apparently you can get them in all sorts of colors. And I don't know why I only got red ones. Maybe I've got another bunch coming in other colors. We'll have to see in future mailbags what shows up.
And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Quite the variety, not the most exciting stuff in the world, but still all quite useful things to have around. Such as this Raspberry Pi Pico RP2040 board. I have a couple of those. I've used a few of them just in fairly mundane projects. They're inexpensive. They're easy to program. If you don't want to learn C, you can program in Python. So just nice to restock and have those around. And then there's these little 5-volt solenoids to add to my accumulation of solenoids to experiment with. One of these days I'll get around to trying to make the project that I had in mind, which is a somewhat musical project that's loosely inspired by Sam from Look Bump No Computer and Liz from Blitz City DIY. They've both done some somewhat percussive projects that use various little types of solenoids, so thought I might try that. Then we have these DuPont jumper wires. Super useful things, cheap enough to be expendable, and when you're doing a bunch of breadboard work, it comes in handy to have those. So thanks to the anonymous donor who sent them in. Then we have this BNC to banana jack adapter, which will go well, actually, with these banana jumpers, just to expand my variety of test leads and test cables and test adapters around here. And then there is these mechanical pencils, carpenter's pencils, they called them. And one thing it mentioned on the listing is there's a little sharpener in there that I hadn't noticed before. So that's kind of cool. A lot of mechanical pencils tend to come with that, but it didn't occur to me for these. So they seem to be implying that these are good for reaching down into a hole. If you've got a hole drilled in something, you want to make a mark or something like that. That is pretty good. I've got some other pens like this type, which are actually a marker, which can reach down inside as well. But these pencils go a lot further. So that's just general workshop toolage. They're relatively inexpensive. They came with far more extra lids than I'm ever going to use. But, well, those could be useful to have around the workshop anyway. Not exactly electronic, which is the theme around here. But sometimes I'm doing things that aren't always electronics. Well, thanks to everybody for watching. Thanks to the anonymous donors who send stuff into the mailbags now and again. Also to my Patreon supporters and YouTube channel members and the Buy Me a Coffee donors who help fund things and keep the beer fridge full. I do appreciate that. And to just all the viewers, thanks for showing up every video and watching right through to the end. I really do appreciate that. Questions and comments down below as usual. I will talk to you later.